Other news now. Another major story this Tuesday is the state visit of Indonesian President Joko Widodo in the Philippines. Manila and Jakarta's foreign ministers reaffirmed their nation's resolve to address issues in the region. Philippine Foreign Secretary Enrique discussed with his Indonesian counterpart strengthening bilateral ties to respond to geopolitical challenges in Southeast Asia and beyond. Jakarta's foreign minister Retno Marsudi, meanwhile, said Indonesia will work with ASEAN member states to finalize a code of conduct in the South China Sea. Also discussed was the Philippines' request for executive clemency to convicted drug mule Mary Jane Veloso. Manalo says the government continues to find ways to commute a death sentence on Veloso. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. first raised the issue with Widodo in his 2022 state visit to Jakarta. Veloso has been on death row since 2015. Indonesia granted a last-minute reprieve to the Filipino national on repeated pleas from the Benigno Aquino III administration.
Nearly 400 people needed medical attention amid the Black Nazarene procession. That tally from the Philippine Red Cross. Over 20 patients had to be transferred to hospitals, while some 135 patients sustained minor injuries. The health department assures the public it is prepared to accommodate those who may need treatment during and after the festivities.
Tuloy-tuloy po, naka-standby po mga medical teams, hindi lang nang sa Department of Health, kundi sa Philippine Red Cross. Maliban sa mga medical station, nagpakalat din yan ng mga maaring mga volunteer na maaring tumulong po kung sakaling mang kailangan po nila ng dagli ang tulong po.
Let's now get the latest from Quiapo in Manila. Our correspondent Zian Ambrosio joins us live with an update. Zian?
More than 100,000 devotees are now here at the Quiapo Church. The police have removed the walk-through scanner and are now doing the frisking in order to give way to the arrival of the carriage of the Black Nazarene. Thousands of devotees of the Black Nazarene took their own spots to get their clear view of the image of the Black Nazarene. Some went up the footbridge, others stayed on top of the fire trucks, while some stayed on the buildings. People were also shouting Bawas Tao or asking the people on the carriage of the Black Nazarene to go down as they were already blocking the view of the Black Nazarene. The Ihos had to ask the devotees to go down. Most of the people who went up the carriage of the Black Nazarene were mostly from the youth sector. According to the PNP, the crowd estimate reached up to more than 3 million people, both in the Traslacion and in Quiapo Church. More than 1 million people joined the Traslacion as monitored by the Quiapo Command Center. According to the Philippine Red Cross, as of 4 p.m., there were 600 patients brought to the medics. Most patients experienced difficulty in breathing, chest pain, hyperventilation, and dizziness. And because of the heat and the big crowd, the fire volunteers used their fire hoses to spray water on the devotees. Based on observation, the scene that we are seeing today is almost similar to the situation of the Traslacion before the pandemic. The difference is it is more faster and lesser people could go up the carriage of the Black Nazarene. As of now, we can see around 500 policemen because they are preparing for the arrival of the carriage of the Black Nazarene. And that's the latest here in Quiapo Church.
Zian Ambrosio with that update. Zian, thank you very much.
President Marcos says over 170 police officers have been charged with drug-related offenses following an intensified anti-drug campaign that focused on law enforcement. The charges include planting of evidence, unlawful arrest, and excessive violence. Marcos adds the Justice Department is pursuing over 150,000 drug cases from 2022 to 2023. Over 121,000 have been jailed due to the illegal drug trade. The Marcos administration also reported it has confiscated around 10.4 billion pesos worth of illegal drugs in 2023.
Para sa amin, hindi lang ito sa mga magandang numero. Kung hindi ay talagang magiging improvement, pinapaganda talaga natin ang komunidad natin, pinapaganda talaga natin ang buhay ng ating mga kababayan at iniiwas natin ang mga kabataan natin diyan sa pagpasok sa lifestyle ng drug taking.
The death toll from the quake that rocked central Japan on January 1st now passed the 200 mark. 102 remain unaccounted for. Rescuers continue search operations amid blocked roads and poor weather conditions. They are also trying to reach nearly 3,500 people stuck in isolated communities. Korean drama star Park Yong-sik, who recently starred in the series Strong Girl Bong-soon, is set to return to the Philippines on February 17 for a fan meeting. Now, speaking to the Philippine media, Park said he hopes to explore the country if his schedule allows. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Anna Cerezo. Anna?
Denise, since it has almost been half a decade since Park Yong-sik last saw his Filipino fans, he promised to make his return to the country on February 17 for his secret timing, an unforgettable one. According to the actor, Pinoy fans can look forward to interactive activities as well as several song numbers. Park last visited the Philippines in 2019, and according to the Strong Girl Bong-soon actor, every aspect of the experience, from the cuisine to the weather, and of course the people, made his trip truly memorable. In fact, the country is among his top preferred travel destinations for a lengthy vacation once he is able to take a break from his demanding schedule. He is interested in visiting its pristine islands to again scuba dive, as he heard the country has some of the best diving spots. He is also interested in trying other activities such as fishing. Filipino fans can also look forward to the actor's upcoming series, Dr. Slump, which Park Hyung-sik said is the most memorable project he has done to date. According to the singer-actor, apart from the shoot being one of the most enjoyable, he was able to relate to the story the most. Dr. Slump will premiere on January 27th.
Thanks, Anna.